Hi guys, SDJ RSNF88 speaking with another update on the GWR 2600 project. Again, I'd like to apologise for the lack in updates on the locomotive. I've been very busy as of late with work and other things, other projects, getting the Garden Railway running again. And really, it's all just trying to find the free time to actually sit down and carry on with this. It's kind of ironic watching the updates, previous updates, especially the first one where I mentioned this was going to be a quick and simple project, and that was over a year and a half ago now. But as you can see, it's all starting to come together now. I mean, just looking at it partly assembled, it's only temporarily assembled, but I'm really pleased with how it's looking so far. I mean, and do tell me what you think of how it looks so far. Of course, there's still quite a way to go, but you can clearly see what the locomotive will hopefully look like when it's complete. So without further ado, let's take a closer look at what I have done. One of the first things that I've worked on since the last update is in fact the livery. As mentioned in that video, I was now going to paint the locomotive black. This was due to the issues I was having with the other paints, especially the khaki paint. And I was just getting too frustrated with it, and I found that the black seemed to be working quite well. And now that I've added a few coats, I am really pleased with how it is looking, and it does look very smart. I'm still a couple of coats away from the finished result. This is because I'm waiting until the kit will be finally assembled to avoid like glue marks and stuff, so they could be painted over, and of course sanding down of certain parts as well. So that final coat will hopefully finish it all off, and it will look quite smart. One of the major obstacles I still have yet to overcome is on how to mount the body and the pony truck to the Lima 09 chassis. Now originally, as mentioned in previous updates, I was thinking of creating an L-shaped frame which would glue onto the running plate here, and I would then slide the body on, a screw would then go up which would hold the pony truck on, and also it would go into this hole on the bottom of the chassis which would subsequently hold the body to the motor block here. Now, that would work in theory, but it would cause a few little issues. The first, it would mean I have to slide the body on, which would mean I would not have a way of connecting the rear of the running plate to the chassis, which could potentially mean there'd be a bit of movement, especially towards the rear with the cab, potentially lifting away from the chassis. Also, I don't think it would have been a strong enough connection, especially for when the train is hauling, the locomotive is hauling a train backwards. So I've had another little think on how I could do this, and I noticed there's a screw hole here which originally would have attached the original body, the 09 body, to this chassis. So I thought maybe I could utilise that hole. So what I'm thinking is if I drill a hole through the running plate here, a small screw would go down through the running plate, through the little hole and out the bottom, and then it will go to a little plastic plate which would be the same width as this plastic plate here. Basically it'd be a little extension which would overhang on the front here, and so it would screw into there. There'd be two little side pieces to keep it nice and straight along with the original bit of plastic there, and then another screw would go up through the front of the running plate about here, and it would hold the pony truck to the plate. Now this would provide a real strong connection, as the screw would be keeping the body nice and tight to the frame. It would also keep the pony truck nice and tight to the chassis, and meaning if it pulls a train backwards, it shouldn't pull away. It also gives me a nice amount of pivot movement on the pony truck there. It also provides a realistic distance between the pony truck itself and the drive wheels and the buffer beam above. And it could also mean, because I now can lower the body over the chassis, mean I could find a way, which I have yet to think of connecting the rear of the running plate to the chassis so it's a much more tighter fit. Now, of course, this all works out on the planning on paper, but of course, it's trying to put this into theory. And that is what I plan to do next. It's one of the things that I've got to really work on, is putting this into reality. And once that has been figured out, I could then actually start assembling the locomotive and making it a permanent fixture. One of the things I've been really concentrating on since the previous update is the construction of the cab. Now, this, I must say, has to be one of the most fiddliest parts of the build I have done so far. In the previous video, you saw me construct the two side pieces, which I built from scratch, as the ones that came with the Truro kit were not the correct size or shape to fit on the locomotive. So I had to fashion my own out of some plasticard, and overall, they look really, really nice when painted up. I've added them to the original front piece and the roof section, which comes with the Truro kit, and I also cut off the grab handles and glued them onto the rear of the ones that I created, given the actual handrails for the locomotive. And it's come together quite nicely, but it took a lot of work to get them in this position. The roof wasn't quite the correct shape when it came out of the bag, and it was playing havoc trying to level it all out and get them together. What I decided to do in the end was to super glue one side to the correct height, let it dry, and then I positioned the roof on before gluing on the opposite side. Even then, they were trying to spring apart. So what I did is I got some matchsticks and I put them in between to keep the width of the the two side pieces away at the bottom. And then I wrapped rubber bands around the roof and around the bottom, which held it together nice and tight. And after a couple of hours drying, it held up, which I'm really pleased with. I reckon it took me a good 2 hours to keep to try and get these pieces together. But it has been well worth it in the end. As you've seen earlier on, once it's on the model, it fits in perfectly and just the way I wanted it to. So I'm really pleased with how it's turned out. Another major leap forward since the last update is, of course, the construction of the tender. Now, as you will remember from previous updates, I have constructed a tender for this locomotive once before, but it went horribly wrong when I tried painting it. I basically started painting it in the khaki livery that I was originally going to paint the whole locomotive in. The paint was not very good and it kept on going different colours, so I decided to try stripping it off. And in doing so, I accidentally melted the actual tender, so I had to go out and buy a new kit. And this is that tender from the new second kit that I had to buy. And like the first tender, it's gone together really, really nicely. The wheels roll nice and smoothly. The buffer beam has gone on well as well. This, of course, will be painted red at a later date, and all the little details will be added, including the buffers, the chain link coupler, the vac pipe, the handles that go on there, and of course I will find a way to mount a loop coupler to the rear as well. But one thing that I never got round to doing on the previous tender before I accidentally melted it was, of course, adding the connection that will connect it between the locomotive. Now, this connector, if I flip it onto its side, is the original connector that comes with the Truro kit, but I've mounted it on the opposite way round. So originally, in the instructions, it would tell you to mount this bit here to the tender. There's a sprue that comes down there, and basically you could lift the tender off that sprue, and this bit here would be glued to the back of the locomotive. But what I've done is I've glued it round the other way round, so this is now glued to the tender, and then this bit will connect to the locomotive. There's a little hole on the bottom of the Lima 09 chassis, which this slots into perfectly. And ironically, this on the outer hole creates the perfect distance between it and the locomotive, meaning that it's a nice realistic-y looking distance, but at the same time it allows the locomotive and tender to negotiate second radius curves and point work, which is perfect for the locomotive. Now, that little pin is not glued in there permanently just yet. It will be at a later date, and then I will paint it black. But it's real nice and tight in there. It will require a bit of force to get it out. So it's sitting in there quite nicely and has given me enough opportunity to test to see if it will work. So the tender has gone together really nicely. Of course, I will need to add another layer of black paint, much like the locomotive, when it's finally complete and all the little details are on there. But for now, I am very, very happy with it. Well, I guess that's all for this update. I hope you enjoyed it. Key things to focus on until next time, I guess, will be the actual mounting of the model. Once I sort out the connection, which will hold the front pony truck, and the actual frames to the chassis, I can then finally start assembling the model permanently. And then it will just be on to adding the final details, the final bit of paintwork, and then hopefully it'll be not long then until we have a complete model and hopefully be able to get her running. So anyway, I hope you enjoyed this short little update. And until next time, this has been SDJR Cinef 88 speaking, and thanks for watching.